everybody, welcome back to my channel. So a lot of you said that you wanted another study with me, and a lot of you said you liked the vlog style, but because today I literally just studied, like I didn't really do anything interesting, I just did this a voiceover one, so I think I'm going to do a mixture of both. So the first thing I did was put on my study playlist, obviously, and I did an hour of vocab. So I did some of it on learn mode because I hadn't done it before, like some of the vocab from this year, which I haven't gone over yet. So I actually learned that vocab, and then I did some of the vocab on just flashcard mode, some of the vocab that I've had to learn for tests this year, so I already know it, because I think there's a big difference between knowing the vocab and learning the vocab. But anyway, I finished all of the Spanish vocab. I've done all 12 topics from Spanish to English, so now I've just got to do them from English to Spanish. But that's another day's issue. Today I was just trying to focus on finishing it the one way, and then I started on topic, oh my god, I don't even know what topic I'm on for German now, like topic eight? I think I'm on topic eight, I want to say. So yeah, I did that for an hour because I was really not in the study mood today, so I thought vocab would get me into it. Then I tried to finish my Gatsby chapter summaries. If you watched my last video, you'll know that I'm just doing a brief summary of all the themes, key quotes, and plot occurrences in Gatsby, just because I'm starting to revise it again because I've left it way too late, as usual, but it's fine. So I was just trying to recap in my brain, and I thought it'd be useful to put at the front of my folder. I didn't quite finish, I've still got chapter 9 to go, and I was being quite strict with myself on my timetable today, so I did everything but chapter 9. And then I went on to Malfi quote revision. So the Duchess of Malfi has a lot of quotes to learn. So the first thing, I was doing Bosler today, who's one of the main characters. He has like the most quotes out of all of them. So I was, to start off with, I just wrote down all of the ones I could remember, which wasn't a lot of them. Then I went through the flashcards and basically read them out to myself and explained them to myself as if I was writing an essay. So I was kind of trying to develop my own points and like justify them whilst comparing them to other texts, hence why you can just see me talking. I honestly don't know any of these flashcards, like Bosler is like, I just don't know them. And after I did Bosler, I went through every single character and typed up all the quotes I could remember, and then in bold I put the ones that I'd forgotten. Most of the characters now, I think I've got most of the quotes down, but Bosler and the Duchess, no, they just don't stick in my head, like they literally just don't stick in my head, because Webster just uses so many freaking words. Like, why do you use so many words, Bosler? I don't know. But anyway, I find like just blurting them out like this is a really good way of remembering them. And if you do this like every couple of weeks before the exam, then the night before the exam, you can just go through them one more time, bam. Then I had a break, just had some snacks. I didn't really have like a proper lunch today because I don't know why, I felt really ill, so like I just didn't eat that much. And of course I was watching How I Met Your Mother, duh. And then I just read the news as well. And then after that break, I finished a practice essay that I started the other day. This nearly stopped me revising for the rest of the day. I literally found this so hard to do. I don't know why. I was really struggling. This question is so hard. The issue is, my texts, you get 7 questions in the exam and you can pick one of them. And the reason I give you 7 is because only one of them usually is relevant to the 2 texts that you're studying in that specific combination, because you can pick from 6 poems and 6 plays. So the combination that I was doing was very specific. So this question really wasn't that relevant because there are literally no other past papers for me to do. So I was trying to do it, but it really just wasn't happening. Like, I just felt like I was completely talking myself in circles and I was getting really, really frustrated. It's way too long as well, and it took me twice the amount of time that it should in the exam, and I'm really not happy with it because you can't put any language analysis in. If you're on OCR, you'll understand me. Also appreciate my cup in the corner. But if you're on OCR, please tell me you're so frustrated with the fact that you cannot analyse language in this section. Like, these 2 texts are the ones with the most amazing language in them, and you have to just talk about context, and it just sounds so wiffly-waffly. Anyway, so I was just trying to write this essay. I didn't even finish it. Like, I couldn't even look it in the eye. I still couldn't bloody finish it. I just gave up with it in the end because it really wasn't helping me. So yeah, that nearly stopped me from revising for the rest of the day. It really, really like put me off, but I forced myself to do an hour of German speaking because my exam is in less than 2 weeks and I'm so behind. So I just revised Einwanderung und Integration. I tried to say that in a German accent, but it came up very English then. Just 2 topics. I just read through my cheat sheets and then I just spoke to myself for about an hour, hence why I didn't really film it that much, because that is all speaking revision is just speaking to yourself and trying to use complex language. And I just used my cheat sheets and went through every single key phrase and key vocab word and tried to make up an answer just from that word or just from that key phrase. And then for another hour, I did Der Vorleser. I am still reading through this. As you can see, like, I've done this with pretty much all of my texts. I'm going through it with the audiobook. And when I first read it, I made these summaries of like what was happening and the key quotes and the key points. So I'm reading through a chapter and then I'm reading through my summary and adding anything that I think I've missed. Genuinely, like, this is kind of passive revision, like I know it is, but unless I've reread all of my texts, and I have 7 of them, I'll get stressed that I don't know them well enough to write an essay. So it's a necessary evil, and it means that when I do revise close to the exam, I'll have just read the text, so it'll be fresh in my head, if that makes any sense. So yeah, I did this for an hour and I nearly finished book one, and I'm starting to panic at how long this is taking me to read, but you know, it's a really easy read considering it's in German. Like, it's a really good book. I would really recommend it. Even if you read it in English, it's such a good book. Like, it's up there with Malfi and The Tempest of like my favourite texts that I study. And then I also read through this revision guide. This isn't actually an Abitur revision guide, which is like the German A level. So basically like A level English revision guide, but for German students. So the language is quite complex, but I've found it's really, really, really been useful to like get that literary perspective in rather than just talking about the plot. Then I had another break, and of course, what was I watching? How Met Your Mother? What a surprise! I've got to season 4 now, and season 4 is my favourite season, so we're good. Then I spent an hour and 20 minutes on a Marxism mind map. So if you're on OCR English, you're going to feel me in that The Tempest has one essay that is 75% language, and then it has one essay which is all critical perspectives, so like different critical frameworks and different critics. So, because OCR is stupid, like this is the only text I have to do this for, but what I've been doing is making mind maps for each critical movement, so Marxism, feminism, post-colonialism, etc. And I've just been putting key terms down the side that I can use in my essay to make myself sound fancy, like androcentrism and like bourgeoisie and proletariat. Then I've got named critics, performance interpretations, and like just general textual analysis of it, so you can have a look at them closer on the screen now. But I found these are really useful to just organize my thoughts, because I really, really like critical perspectives and I love The Tempest, so I'm quite happy to sit for hours doing those. Then I spent 50 minutes revising my German independent research project. Mine is on the Reichstag, which is the German parliament building, if you wanted to know. A lot of you have asked me. So as you can see here, I'm just practicing my presentation, which is 2 minutes long. In a minute, you should be able to hear me chatting, I think. I think I left a little bit in if you want to hear me.
Hier schlägt das Herz der Demokratie oder es schlägt nicht, sagte der ehemalige Bundespräsident Norbert Lammert. Obwohl das heutige Parlament das Volk repräsentiert, ist das Reichstagsgebäude eng verbunden mit der turbulenten deutschen Geschichte der vergangenen 130 Jahre. In den ersten 100 Jahren seines Bestehens war das Gebäude nur ganze 38 Jahre lang tatsächlich Heimat für eine gewählte Volksvertretung.
So then I literally sat for 50 minutes and just went through all of my, like, I've put prepared questions in. Like, I know that they might not ask me these, but it's just a good way of formulating my ideas and my thoughts, and I literally just sat and spoke to myself. I haven't memorized these answers. I'm just trying to do it so I can say them on the spot and just make it up on the spot. But yeah, if you want to know more about my independent research project, I can totally tell you about it, because it's my favorite thing on my German A level. I find it really, really interesting. I picked the best topic. And then once I'd finished revising, I watched a few Study With Me's, which sounds really weird because I finished revising, but I actually find them really relaxing to watch. I don't know why. And yeah, I just like seeing what everyone else has been up to. So I watched a bit of Perks of Law, a bit of Evie Flynn, and a bit of Holly Gabrielle, because they'd all uploaded Study With Me's whilst I'd been revising all day. And yeah, I love these three, so defo go subscribe to all of them. And then I just put on some Deutsch Pop. This playlist is so good. Like, I don't really like German music that much, but this is good German music. And then I spent about 25 minutes replying to comments on my latest Study With Me. Thank you all so much for the lovely comments, by the way. Really, really, really nice. And I'm really glad that you like the vlog style. And I'm definitely going to return those orange trousers, because I feel the same way. Anyway, so I still haven't turned my phone on at this point, because I actually just don't like listening to my phone, like reading my phone, like looking at my phone. And I was just listening to this song, which is really, really good, Schatten ohne Licht. And then I tidied up my room, and now the dogs are barking. Can you please shut up? Shush. Anyway, I'm just here tidying up my room because I don't like going to bed with mess everywhere. And obviously because I'm at my dad's, like, it's all in the suitcase anyway. So all I've got to do is shove it all back in the suitcase. Yeah, what a stress. If you've got divorced parents, you feel the stress in exam season. It's such a pain. And then I just spent 5 minutes, not even that, like 3 minutes, just typing out what I want to do tomorrow, because I'm really getting close to the end of Easter holidays and I just want to finish everything that I want to get done so I can go back and do basically nothing for the next 4 weeks and not feel guilty about it. yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a big, big thumbs up, and I will see you very, very soon with a new video. Bye, guys!